I had 28 nights in the desert with my car when I didn't have a house. Like, it was always there, as I said, that since I was young, because it was like maybe 15 or 14 years old when I started my first drag racing. Every car was excited for me, anything what was there in the car, like from engines to the gearboxes. I was seeing the even the sticks, and sometimes just car without anything, it's just skull inside. It still was so attractive to me, to see the car, like how it is from inside, like seeing the gearbox, seeing how it's connected to the engine, what is the clutch, flywheel. Okay, wow, I never know that. So that's how I get to know. And yeah, about the gauges, I was impressed, but I don't really remember the story, because time to time I start, like it was many things which come across slowly, so I was always into this, that's why. And yeah, the most exciting moment for me, it was after the crash, when I start my car from the scratch and I've seen my chassis of my Nissan single without anything. Just I was like, wow, this is my chassis. So let's start from the scratch. I was like so excited about this. The gearbox, it was there, I didn't change, it was fine, but the engine gone. It was LS400 that days. As well, I like flames in the cars. I like backfires, which I was always there to complement with other things on the car. So the first, I think the first mostly I look at the car when it's not how it look like, how it loud is it, what is the engine. If I hear something, first of all, open the bonnet, I want to see what is the engine. What did you do to that to have this loud engine and long flame or middle frame or flame or whatever? And yeah, the social media was against me. Like, I had to provide them a video, which I had only the video when I had that it was not me, to stand my name and stand the names for ladies, because I'm sorry, you call us chickens, it's like not correctly. How you can even say that? Okay, many can do mistakes, and you just can understand the situation and see it. And then I understand that, yes, I agree, many ladies, they doesn't have that skill of driving. A priori, I can say from the genus, yeah, from the genetic, but it's fine. Still, it's ability when you can grow and slowly build it up. It depends on the needs, it depends on the priorities. And if me, I was since childhood like this, I found the petrol in my wines, in my wines, literally, yes. And yeah, the engine in my heart and mind. I'll tell you the reason why I don't choose the two another one, but direct I will come to the point of the GTM, the most attractive, the most loudness, the most loved. This is the GTM. I can say more about this, there is a list never ends, but you know, I still have many people who into love with German cars and muscle cars, and I respect them for their choices as well. But my heart is still for GDM. The night I slept in patrol, you know, I had 28 nights in the desert with my car when I didn't have a house. But still in that days, I was going to rally and participating in it when no one even get a clue that I didn't have a house, and I was eating half sausage a day to economy, because I need to put the petrol, because I need still to driving. That's crazy I was. And this is the only my home which saved me, it's a car. So like basically I was going to the desert and I was making a fire and I was sleeping. I took this time as not bad time, I took as a challenge and activities. So I decided, okay, let's see why I have to be sad about this, why I have to cry into the pillow and scream to the world that I don't have a house, I don't have a money because I had this situation, but I still want to move on with my goals. I still have them. And going to the rally, the days when I was sleeping in the car and I knew that I don't know where to come back the next day, I still was keeping on with racing. When I go to make a test and test day or train day with my car, and I understood that I'm not ready with my dress and it's not rally time, but I already passing by that area, so let me make a test because rally is tomorrow basically. So I didn't have even track, no, I don't know the track, so let me get to know the track. And I was in a long dress with bare foot because I usually don't like to wear my shoes, and I came like gypsy. That where it was coming from. And it was Jeep Cherokee, black color, automatic. I went to the test track totally alone in the desert, and I was jumping out from one dune to another dune, going to the curve, and I was having a sense, when I'm driving I was having a sense to the car, like how the car is behave, what's happening, what is going on right or wrong, and I always listen. And that moment I was listening like something wrong, I cannot understand yet, because it's, that was the first time when it's happened to me, because I had different situation, breaking of suspension, breaking of engine, anything, but not this. And I will tell you what. I stopped the car and I could hear the flame in the car, and I was freezed for maybe a few seconds, and I realized that I was having this rally belt and fire extinguisher next to another seat fixed. I don't know which power I had, or how I could I just reach this, and without again this condition of mind switch to the emergency, I took the fire extinguisher, I came outside the car. I understand that I can't open the bonnet to give them more oxygen, it's just impossible. What I will do, I cannot. Let's see if it's little the fire, so I can deal with this. I go down, and there was a lot of safety, the roll cage everywhere, and I don't know how to reach the engine, and I can see the flame. I start putting this pipe to closer, and I know that I was afraid to burn myself. Also, I'm within a dress without shoes. Girl, you stop, and I'm in rally. I'm in the rally car with this fire extinguisher standing in the middle of nowhere. Nobody's there. I'm alone, and I'm trying to calm the fire down. And I understand that in 1 second, I done. When I was checking that everything is fine, I see the drop of oil, and then I realized that was the extinguisher is already empty, and I cannot do anything at all in this moment. I just threw in it what I have sent. I was trying to dig, I don't know what I was doing, like a cat in the sand doing something. And it's very important to understand when you still can save situation and when you still have to stop, when you have to save yourself, your life, from something is worse happening. And there are, by the way, three types of people who cannot stop, and they just feeling pity to the situation, they must do something, they're losing control. And another people, they know when to stop in the right moment. And another people, when they give up in the very beginning, they cannot even do anything, they just locked and shocked.